So far, we have only talked about the path of the individual. The key, the magic word for the creation of the new world, however, is community. It is not by accident that one of the books of Agni Yoga bears this title. The world of the future can only be imagined as a community of new men. Isolated Agni Yogis, left to their own, cannot establish the world of the future. However many they and however great their efforts may be, we will conquer the world not as individuals, but only as a community. Only in unity is strength. The small, isolated efforts at saving the planet are very weak. Truth, justice, beauty, and love are to rule among all people, in human society as a whole. The community stands as the only door to progress. Pushing off from the old shore, humanity inevitably will reach the indicated evolutional upright cliff of the new world. So, how shall we build the world of the future? By joining forces with like-minded people, forming communities, and placing them under the rule of the Mahatmas. We start with small core groups that others can join. Thus, larger communities arise. Soon, a village, several cities, and finally an entire country will come under the rule of the Mahatmas. In the end, through natural development, the world community emerges. Thus, even in small core groups, one can thrust forward the prototype of world progress. In governmental and social construction, one should have in mind the workings of cosmic laws. Two harmonized auras can create a new world. A group of 12, systematically united, truly can master even cosmic events. It must be understood that the enlarging of such a group can weaken it, undermining the dynamic of the construction. Therefore, you notice that our construction consists of small groups. The world state temple of humanity is created through merging many small, medium, larger, and largest communities. Thus, beginning with the seed, the construction of a community can result in the community of the world. One of the most beautiful statements of Agni Yoga is: let new communities arise as new springs in the desert. Around each spring, tender grass will become green, and the streams from the springs will eventually flow together in one current. The picture of an oasis might perhaps seem a little worn out today, But here it is completely justified. We need to set up lighthouses, points of light, living, shining examples of a more spiritual way of life in the midst of the spiritual desert of today's time. Like the Christians in the declining Roman Empire, we are laying the foundation for a higher culture. Furthermore, we must create homesteads in which spiritual people, the first representatives of the coming sixth race, can find refuge. How are we going to proceed practically? What are the first steps? Let us start very practically, very simply, very small and from bottom up. The first, most obvious, most natural, and most necessary step in forming a community is we meet once a week to study and discuss the books of Agni Yoga. This does not require any material means, no rooms other than the apartment of one of the participants, and no living together. If these study evenings not only theorize, but actually advance the spiritual development of the individual members, you are already doing extremely valuable, fruitful work. The books of Agni Yoga are the basis for all of our endeavors. They are still new to all of us. Studying them thoroughly, really internalizing them, and putting their instructions into practice is therefore an indispensable prerequisite for the new construction. You will see, it turns out already here who is suitable to work in a more ambitious community and who is not. Soon, after just a few weeks, the wheat separates from the chaff. There are those who simply do not manage to attend regularly or to show up on time. There are those who, with their undisciplined nature, bring nothing but chaos into the group, be it because they lack the necessary seriousness or because their technology never works. Or those who are not interested in Agni Yoga at all, but wish to present their own world view. There are others who are so deeply stuck in their personal problems that they are not yet mentally ripe to focus on Agni Yoga. When discussing the paragraphs, it quickly transpires who is a spiritual person. Some understand quite well what the Master wants to tell us, give valuable examples on the explanation of a passage, help other members to understand, and give suggestions on how the teaching can be applied in everyday life. Others, on the other hand, gain no access, neither to the books nor to the explanations given by the group, do not want to listen, talk too much or persistently past the matter, ask questions and make contributions that have nothing to do with the topic, and so on. Even in such a small group of the very first level, it soon becomes apparent where humans are, they are human. Sympathies and antipathies come to light. There is irritation, offense, and even aggressiveness.
One of you, observing what is taking place, becomes a self-appointed overseer and sinks into the pettiest irritation. The fabric of the communion is torn and an unworthy mending is begun.
Not unlike later in larger physical communities, we must find a way to deal with the manifold, inevitable human weaknesses in a dignified and goal-fitting manner.
When studying the books of Agni Yoga together, not only the individual learns and develops, but also the community.
Even by the comparatively simple test of study evenings, it quickly becomes clear who is eligible for secular or spiritual leadership of the group, who promises to become a good co-worker and disciple, who only goes along passively with the others, and who will even have to be excluded. According to the law of correspondence, when valuable work is being done in the group, we can expect to attract like-minded spirits.
Of course, any new construction attracts the consciousnesses most akin to it.
Those who are committed to our work will perhaps be able to inspire family members or friends to take part in such an evening. This is how the community grows naturally. When such a core group is established, but only then, you may dare to go public, offer introductory evenings to Agni Yoga for outsiders. Thereby, you are making a first contribution to anchoring Agni Yoga in society. However, such a step needs to be carefully considered. The group must already present a worthy sight. Nothing is more harmful than when newcomers encounter disagreement, strife, quarreling, or trivial coffee table gossip with everyday chatter. This turns not only against the group, but also against Agni Yoga as a whole.
My young friends, again you have been gathered in the name of the teaching, and again you have had an evening with guests. Whereas it has been said and repeated that the hour of discourse about the teaching must be devoid of ordinary gossip. Even though this hour may be more infrequent, yet its quality must be upheld. We urge you, even if for only an hour, to be consciously responsible people. If an hour a week is difficult for you, then better meet only every fortnight. Learn how to exclude at that time all troublesome, beastly habits, smoking, drinking, eating, shallow gossip, the turnover of your small affairs, censure, anger. Surely for 1 hour one can dismiss personal ventures.
You may also place advertising for such an offer.
Isn't it unworthy to publicly extol such a high teaching?
No, not if it is done in an appropriate place and in an adequate, dignified form. It is not forbidden,
to draw public attention to a public event. When Nicolas Roerich organized an exhibition of his paintings, it was, of course, also advertised. Otherwise, you cannot expect people to pour in. Of course, it is best to meet in person. However, the disciples do not necessarily have to live in the same place and come together physically. With today's technical possibilities, we can hold study evenings across national borders beyond the restrictions of time and space, for example, via Skype or Zoom.
Study evenings are the nucleus of the new construction in all countries all over the world.
Whoever wants to become a member of a community of the new world has to learn, as when converting to Judaism, Christianity or Islam, as in a Torah or Quran school or in confirmation classes, not only the worldview of Agni Yoga, but also its customs and practices, as well as their application in daily life. So let us take another step of paramount importance towards the building of a community.
Above all else, we need schools that systematically teach both the theory and the practice of Agni Yoga.
He who wants to participate in the construction of the world of the future must know a lot. The laws of existence, such as karma, rebirth, evolution, and hierarchy. He has to transform into an immortal being of spirit. For this, he needs help from those who have already climbed that level. Finally, we have to teach him, in theory, the rules of living together that Agni Yoga establishes, and train them with him in practice.
To achieve this, we have to extract from the thousands of pages of the Agni Yoga books a complete study and exercise program.
This program must encompass all the knowledge of Agni Yoga and all aspects of daily practice. Working out something like this is a gigantic challenge. For this, we need teachers who, in addition, must be able to convey this crystallized knowledge to newcomers simply and clearly.
How can I help? I am not a teacher. I haven't even read all the books of Agni Yoga yet.
It is important that you realize creating a complete and systematic program of learning and practice is not a matter for one single teacher alone. The result will be of high quality only if it is not thought out theoretically, but has been tried and tested many times over in practice. Its suitability is proved only in everyday use. Based on the experiences we are making with this program, it must be constantly revised and refined. You can make a valuable contribution to this by sharing the experiences you have made. The Agni Yoga schools are intended for members and outsiders, newcomers, beginners, and advanced learners of all ages. Establishing them is very important and extremely valuable, regardless of whether we later actually come to the formation of a physical community or not.
A school like Plato's Academy still today exerts an influence on mankind through its writings, even if the ideal republic devised by Plato has not yet become a reality on the material level.
At all times, in all cultures, religions, and worldviews, schools where higher knowledge was taught have been centers for spreading a new higher civilization. Because parents entrusted their children to them, hoping that they would learn a better, superior way of life there. The teachers in these schools will be the future leaders of the community.